Welcome to the video lecture. Today we will talk about heat treatment process. So at first we need to know what is heat treatment process. Basically, heat treatment is defined as an operation involving the heating and cooling of a metal or an alloy in the solid state to obtain certain desirable properties without change of composition. The process of heat treatment is carried out to change the grain size, to modify the structure of the material, and to relieve internal stresses and set up material after hot or cold one. Why the heat treatment process is generally done? The heat treatment process is done to improve machinability, to improve magnetic or electrical properties, to increase resistance to wire and to air, heat, corrosion, and much more. And how this heat treatment process is done? Basically, the heat treatment process consists of heating the metal near or above its critical temperature. That's why you need to know what is critical temperature first. Remember the iron carbon diagram. The critical temperature is temperature where the material is changing its crystal structure to its another form. In this case, alpha ferrite is changing at 723 degrees centigrade up to 0.8% of carbon content is changing to its start changing to its another form, say austenite. So above this line, above this 723 degrees centigrade of 0.8 or any percentage of carbon, the alpha ferrite will start change to austenite, and it will end up of changing nearly about 910 degrees centigrade when there will be 0% of carbon content, and as the carbon content increases, this temperature will decrease. And see, at 0.8%, this temperature will be 723 degrees. So this is called lower critical temperature when the crystal structure will start changing, and this is upper critical temperature when it will complete its change to another form, say austenite. And see, at 0.8% carbon, this lower and upper critical temperature has been coincide. This is same. That means that 0.8% carbon at 723 degree, as the alpha ferrite suddenly change into austenite, it will not occur alpha plus austenite or ferrite plus austenite form. So in this region we can see there will be ferrite plus austenite form. As the temperature will increases, more ferrite will be transformed into austenite. The percentage of austenite will increase, the percentage of ferrite will decrease. So heat treatment consists of heating of metal near or above critical temperature held for a particular time at the finally cooling the metal in some medium, which may be air, water, molten salt, etc. The heat treatment process, including annealing, case hardening, tempering, normalizing, and quenching, nitriding, cyanidizing, etc. These are the types of heat treatment: annealing, normalizing, hardening, tempering, nitriding, cyanidizing, induction hardening, flame hardening. Basically, there are 8 types. We'll get to know the types of heat treatment and the purpose. How the heat treatment process has been done and application of those heat treatments. First of all, take annealing process. Annealing is one of the most important process of the heat treatment. It is one of the most widely used operation in the heat treatment of iron and steel, and is defined as the softening process. Annealing is generally softening process. It is done heating from 30 to 50 degree centigrade above upper critical temperature. This is the upper critical temperature of the iron. Depending upon percentage of carbon, we will take upper critical temperature. Say if the percentage of carbon is 0.8, upper critical and lower critical is same, that will be 723 degree. As the percentage of carbon will decrease, the upper critical temperature will also decrease. At 0% carbon content of steel, it will say 910 degree centigrade is the upper critical temperature. So 30 to 50 degree above upper critical temperature, it will be heated, the steel will be heated and cooling at very slow rate by seeking in the furnace. Inside the furnace, the cooling process will turn by very slow rate. The main of annealing is to make steel more ductile. The annealing process will make more ductile, the material more ductile, malleable, and it will remove the internal stresses. This process generally makes the steel soft so that it can be easily machined. So let's see what are the purpose of this annealing. Number one, it softens the steel and to improve its machinability. It refines grain size and remove gases from the material. It removes the internal stresses and developed during the previous process. Suppose we have done many more forces previously on that particular material. So some internal stresses have been generated inside the material. This process, this annealing process, will remove these internal stresses. Number four, to obtain desired ductility. Suppose the material was harder, we need to machine that. We know harder material is difficult to machine in. That's why we make those material ductile. That means we will improve the ductility, malleability, toughness of the material. Number five, it modifies the electrical and magnetic properties of the material also. Now, what will be procedure of this annealing process? Depending on the carbon content, the steel is heated to a temperature of about 50 to 55 degree or 30 to 40 degree above its critical temperature range, upper critical temperature. It is held at that temperature for a definite period of time, depending on the type of furnace and the nature of work. Then the steel is allowed to cool inside the furnace very slowly. Okay, this is the procedure. This application of annealing process is to, it is applied generally on casting and forging. Our next attainment process is normalizing. What is normalizing? Normalizing is the main aim of normalizing is to remove internal stresses developed after cold working process. All of you aware about cold working process, I have teach you previously. So after cold working process, there will be some internal stresses. We need to remove that. So in this, the steel will be heated above upper critical temperature and cooling in the air. Just it will be heated above upper critical temperature. Depending upon carbon percentage, it will be heated above 30 to 50 degree centigrade of upper critical temperature, and it will be left in air and cooling air gradually. What this normalizing process may basically done? It improves mechanical and electrical properties, machinability, tensile strength. It is the process of heat treatment carried out to restore the structure of normal condition. Suppose after cold working process, some internal stresses has been generated. That means the system crystal structure has been changes, and we need to restore the crystal structure. Okay,
What is the purpose of normalizing? To promote uniformity of structure. If internal stresses will be situated, there will be no uniformity. That means there will be some strain inside the material. We will remove that. We will get back the material in uniformity. We will refine the grains. The grain structure will be apodized, and we'll refine that and secure the grain refinement and bring about desirable changes of properties of steel. Suppose we need to make more ductile, we will do annealing, a normalizing process. Now, what is procedure of this normalizing process? The steel is heated to a temperature about 40 to 50 degree above its upper critical temperature. Then it is held at this temperature for a short duration. Then the steel is allowed to cool in steel air at room temperature, which is known as air quenching. That means we will let the material at normal room temperature and get left it to cool it down. This is the procedure basically. Application of the normalizing is, it is applied to casting and forging to refine grain structure and to relieve internal stresses. It is applied after cold working, as I have told you, such as rolling, stamping, hammering. Okay. Our next is hardening process. Now, what is hardening? The main aim of the hardening process is to make the steel hard and tough. In previous two processes, annealing and normalizing, we are making the material softer and ductile. In hardening process, we will making the material harder and tough. The process, steel is heated 30 to 40 degree above upper critical temperature, then followed by continue cooling to room temperature by quenching in water or oil. And generally, it is the process opposite process of annealing. So, quenching in water or oil will cool the material rapidly, and if we cool the material, the crystal structure and grain structure will be changed in that way that it will become harder. Purpose of hardening? By hardening, it is increased hardness of the steel. It is resist wear and tear. It allows steel to cut other materials. If the steel will be harder, that steel will cut other materials, other softer materials, other ductile materials. That's why we harden the material. Now, procedure of hardening is, the steel is heated above its critical temperature range, 30 to 40 degree above upper critical temperature. It is held at this temperature for a definite period of time. For some time, we will hold that temperature. Then the steel is then rapidly cooled in a medium of quenching. Quenching means rapidly cool into water or air. The quenching medium is selected according to the degree of hardness desired. That means whatever we desire, up to what extent we desire to harden the material, we'll choose the quenching process. It will be water quenching or oil quenching. It will be depending upon our desired hardness. The air, water, oils, molten salts are used for quenching medium. A thin section such knife blades are cooled in air. Water is widely used medium, but it results the formation of bubbles on the surface of material. That's why we will use generally oil. Hence, Bryan solution is prevent this bubble form. Oil is also used. There is risk of distortion or crack and is suitable for alloy steels. The molten salts are used to cool the section to obtain crack-free impact resistance product. Okay. Now, what are the applications? It is applied for chisel, sledgehammer, hand hammer, center punch, taps, dies, milling cutters, knife blades and gears. So, that type of hard material we require
to produce by hardening process. Next is tempering. Tempering, when the hardening process hardens a steel specimen, it becomes brittle. As we try to make the material harder, it will become brittle. It will lose its ductility. Okay? And high residual stress will occur inside. So, tempering is the operation used to modify the properties of steel hardened by quenching for the purpose of increasing its usefulness. After hardening process, whatever residual stress will be there, that will be removed by tempering process. The tempering or draw result in a reduction of brittleness and removal of internal strains caused during hardening. Steel must be tempered after hardening process. The tempering is divided into three categories according to usefulness of the steels. Low tempering, temperature tempering, medium temperature tempering, high temperature tempering. These are the three different types of tempering process depending upon our desired hardness or ductile flow in the material. We'll do that type of tempering. So after hardening process, we should do tempering process for our desired material. Now see purpose of tempering: to relieve internally stressed caused by hardening, to reduce brittleness after hardening, to improve ductility strength and toughness, to increase wear resistance, to obtain desired mechanical properties. As per our requirement, we will do that type of tempering, low temperature or medium or high temperature, as per our requirement of desired mechanical properties, we will do that type of tempering. So basically, procedure of tempering is the steel, after being quenched in the hardening process, is heated to a temperature slightly above the temperature range at which it is to be used, but below the lower critical temperature. Below this lower critical temperature, we will improve the temperature. The temperature here varies from 100 degree to, this is 723 degree centigrade, to 100 to 700 degree centigrade. Within this region, we'll heat the material. The reheating is done in a bath of oil or molten lead or molten salt. The specimen is held in a bath of period of time till attain the temperature evenly. The time depends on the composition and desired quality of steel. Now the specimen is removed from the bath and allowed to cool slowly in a steel air. So after increase the temperature within this zone below the lower critical temperature up to 700 degrees centigrade, we will put this material inside the oil which will be heat enough, and after keeping in that oil or salt, molten salt, we will get desired type of mechanical properties, and we will remove material from that quench oil or molten salt and allow it to cool at room temperature. Or yeah, this is the tempering process generally. Application of tempering is, it is applied to cutting tools, gears, which is hardened by the hardening process. So basically, this heat treatment process we are doing to change the mechanical properties accordingly our desired mechanical properties. So this is the first four for today. The second part, from nitriding to flame hardening, we will discuss in next class. Thank you.